Hey guys, welcome to the Testing Academy. My name is Pramod and welcome to the Cypress tutorial. And here in this tutorial, what we are going to do is that we are going to learn some advanced Cypress commands. So let's get started. So in this video, we are going to understand lots of different Cypress commands. I'll basically start from scratch and basically give you most of the commands that you are going to use in Cypress. Trust me guys, this is one of the important tutorial and I will basically explain you lots of different commands which definitely going to help you to create your automation. These commands are must to know before starting out your any kind of Cypress automation. Alright, so before starting this tutorial, I would like to tell you that I have created lots of API testing tutorials related to the Postman API testing. If you want to learn about it, do check out in the playlist section of this channel. Do check out the Selenium interview question and answers, Cypress tutorials from scratch, creating a live project. So we have created a live project also. We have started Cypress tutorial for beginners, right? And in the upcoming videos, we are coming up with some advanced page object pattern Cypress tutorials. So be ready for that. I have created lots of automation mindset videos where we mostly discuss about how to switch from manual to automation. All right, so let's get started. So these are the main commands that I am going to discuss. That these are visit, get, should, find, filter, parent, each, and clear, click, fixture, and get cookie. So and there are few more of them. And so we are going to go one by one. If I miss some of the command, definitely these are the commands which are definitely going to cover in some future videos. So don't worry about it. All right. So let's do one thing. Let's come to for your reference, I have already created a project and everything is there, right? Every kind of command I have already created. So I'm not gonna type in front of you because that will take a lot of different time. I'm gonna explain you everything from scratch. So let me close other. So if you are new to Cypress and if you haven't like this is your first tutorial, let me show you how to create a Cypress project. So you need to create any directory. For example, let's create a YT Cypress, right? Let's cd into it. Now what you can do is that if you have Cypress installed on your system, you can first you need to create a node project. I will highly recommend you to basically create a node project. And after that, you can just do add a dev dependency of Cypress, right? So after adding the dev dependency of Cypress, what you need to do is that you need to run a command called as Cypress open. That will basically create a folder structure of your Cypress. Okay. So after this, what you need to do is let me show you. So it's done. Let me clear it out. What you need to do is that there's a node folder. Cypress bin. Cypress, I'm gonna do open, right? So it will open a Cypress GUI, which is known as Cypress runner also. And when it starts, it's basically will create a default folder structure of your Cypress. I'm gonna click close. And as you can see, we have a tree. Oh, it's long. So if I do at ls, only ls, so you can see that the folder structure is ready. So let me come to my demo. Already created demo, I'll not create in front. So this is the folder, typical folder structure looks like. So we have package json that we have created. We have log file, which is, you can ignore this one. We have Cypress json, which is empty file. We have the node module folder, which is basically all the node modules, and this is the most important folder, which is Cypress. Right, in this Cypress we have fixtures, we have integration code where you will write all the files, and all the test cases are written in spec files, right? We have plugins, screenshots, support, videos, and index.html. It is not there. This is the file that I have created. Okay, the first thing first is that how to use a visit file. So most of the command that you see, especially with the Cypress, are starts with cy. Right, the typical structure of the Cypress test cases looks very similar to the Mocha, because the test runner behind the Cypress is Mocha, right? So how it looks like is that, let me show you, let me create a new file. So let's save it. Let's create an integration folder. Let's make it demo.spec.js. If you are creating any kind of test file, you need to basically name .spec.js, right? Everything is JS. JS file, you need to typically type a describe block, which takes a, can say, a callback function, and after that you need to write it blocks. It blocks are smaller test cases, you can say. Yeah, so here you will write code, and then this is the typically describe blocks. Again, this next state. So this is a basically a block structure kind of a thing, which is very similar to most of the test JavaScript test runners like Jasmine, Mocha. So typically they have describe blocks, and in the describe block they have it basically blocks. These are the blocks which are basically synchronous. So the first it will run, after the second it. I hope that makes sense. Right? So let's start with the cy.visit. So I know a lot, if you go to the Cypress documentation, you will get to know that, okay, these are the things, but I'll explain you lots of interesting points here. If you want to visit any kind of remote URL, you need to use cy.visit. Okay, so cy.visit is very wonderful command, which basically takes, you can give google.com, for example. You can give any local server that you are running. For example, right now I'm running at 8080, right? And interesting thing is that if you, you can also pass certain options also. So there are like options related to timeout. For example, you want to get this URL, but you want to make sure that till 30 seconds we want to wait if that URL is not available. You can do that. You need to pass options in a JavaScript kind of a thing, right? Key value pair. You can also do retry on network failures, right? And there are like couple of more options available, like retries after 4 times, something like this, right? So you can do that also. So if you are creating, I know it's kind of a wonderful command, right? Use it, because you can use retry on network failure. So suppose you first time you run due to some not network configuration, you were not able to connect to this local server that you are testing, or you are staging any staging environment, you can do retry on network. So this is the thing that you can do. Interesting point second is that Cypress cannot access the file system, so this will not work, right? Okay, that makes sense. Another point here is that you can use cyber.visit, and you can pass a JSON object containing key value pairs, key containing key as a URL and method as a post, or you can say get, right? Similarly, it's very similar, right? So if you are testing any kind of a API that maybe you're thinking that I can use ci.visit, right? But I won't recommend, because if you are doing a API testing or making a get, post, put, patch request, ci.request is a wonderful way to do that, right? Here you need to mention all the things. So cy.request is basically a wonderful way to make an API request rather than cy.visit. Visit is just basically used to visit a remote URL. Alright, I hope that makes sense. If I how you can run this test, it's very simple. You will you need to type Cypress, right, and run. Make sure that you have installed Cypress on your global. I typically do that by using npm install -d cypress, right? After you are done, cypress command will be available anywhere. Also, you can run by node modules cypress in cypress. These are same thing. Cool. So cypress, you need to mention run. After that, in second, you can basically give the spec file. So spec file, suppose I want to run probably in a directory. See what is y command. Right. So you can do is that you after spec you can mention the spec file, And after that, you can also mention the browser. Similarly, we have one more option, like few more options are there. You can pass environment a variable. env is equal to key is equal to key that you can use directly into cy by using cy.env value. That I explained in other videos. Okay, so that might that will not make much sense. So let's do one thing. Let's run the visit spec file. So it will start. If you see that Cypress runner has started, it's behind the scene. Will open the Chrome browser, right? And the by default the resolution is 1000 by 660. It's okay because the first test case we are running. So the cy.visit.google.com will be done, and after that we have like 8080. We have admin LTE. So there's another URL that that is not present as of now, but okay. So basically, it is trying to get 8081 because 8081 is. So if you have seen it, it basically have retried, right? Because it was network failure. But yeah. So if we do again run the test, it will pass. So this is all about the cy.visit. Cypress has a very, very wonderful I would say documentation where you will get most of the details about any kind of command, and I'll show you how you can understand all the things. Okay. To Cypress commands, especially because everything is there, you just need to basically plug all these commands in. So a test case is there. So if you go to here, you will type visit from the visit one. So as you can see, they have a very wonderful explanation that you can pass options also, right? Options include this thing, kind of headers, also query parameter. You can use all of them, right? So let's move on to the next command, which is my favorite basically, and it's basically get. So if you want to, for example, this is the URL that we wanted to open. So let me show you how it looks like. So this is the input URL and I want to get the number text, right? So you can basically get in the get part, you can basically, you have to mention the locator of this basic element, right? Whenever you do that, you can do as. So basically if you want to assign as a variable, right? In most of the time, what we wanted to do is that a is equal to this thing, right? This thing don't work. So it's basically a promise based framework. So basically the get will basically return something. So you can use as, which basically assigned to this variable, and if you want to reuse this variable, you can use a at the rate. So if you do cy.get a, it will basically return the p tag, and it will, we are basically tagging with a should. The should is like a kind of a, there are like implicit and explicit way kind of assertions, right? But basically should will basically, you can say, very aggressive way to test the assertion that it should have the number. If we are expecting something, it means we expect that actual result with the our actual result with the expected result, right? But in the should, we are basically, we are aggressively testing that it should be a number. So similarly, you can run this command also. What you need to do is that you need to change these two get. It will basically try will run, and make sure that in the get you are basically mentioning the locators. So, and you can use as also if you want to basically assign to a certain variable, you can do that with the as. Most of the time these are the things that we have done, especially in the fixtures part, right? So if you haven't watched my tutorial, do it. So after get we have a good spec. It's basically very similar. We have already used a should, right? So this is the should that we have used. Similarly, we are going to input tag. We are assigning it to variable. You can have a have text with a value. You can check for should be empty. should be visible, should with have .css. If you want to check that if this p tag have a CSS or contains a font family or not, you can have should or dot attribute. You can check the attributes, like for example, if you have added data QA or any kind of attribute, then you can check that also. You can have not to have all, so or either way, right? Similarly, for example, this way we are basically assigning it to number text, right? We are basically should, and this is one of the interesting way to check it out. Basically, should returns a promise. Means after in should you can basically pass the variable, and again here you can expect, right? So it's another interesting concept where instead of directly adding, for example, I don't want have text, I want it to basically check for length or anything else, I can do what I can do is that I will do a should dot should, basically pass the to the variable, and that variable I can use this. This is very similar to the chai.js, if you know assertions, expectations of the chai.js. It basically follows that, right? So I hope that makes sense. So if you run this, basically the number have a length of one because there is only one p tag, right? And it should contain number text. So that will again, don't want to run it right now, but yeah, you need to get, yeah, means you get, you'll get it. All right. So let's move on to this important one, which is find, which is very, very interesting one. Let me tell you, this is the concept that you need to understand, because if you are able to understand this concept, this will basically get, for example, I want to click this button, edit, right? So what is the, how I can do that? So if we go to this one, this is the TD tag. So first of all, we have a table one, right? And what you can do is that you can get this table by using cy.get, right? After that, I want to find this first tr. So I can do tr.findTr. And after that, I can use first method. So I can do tbody.tr or directly can do tr also and first. So we'll have this one. So this first tr will be available. And after that, what I'm doing is that first I want to find the td and I want to find the a. So after this one I want to find the td. So any td, so suppose I have find the td, but it should contain a, right? Because I have written that find td and after that find a, and whichever first a you find, just click on it. So all the tds are there, but the first, but it contains a tag, so that will be clicked again. So if we do a click, nothing happens, just edit, we have a URL change that we can also verify. We can basically do a URL command where we can check that we do a match, then basically check if it contains edit or not, right? So let's run it and see if we can if we are right or not. Start running. So it's going to open the, you see it, tables is a URL as of now, and it clicks the edit button. So everything is passed, means our URL check is also fast, right? So cy.url, make sure URL is after the visit one. So it will check for the visited URL. Okay. So you need to mention that, you need to basically check. This URL will be the this URL after doing the get method. If we have clicked, so it will basically be changed URL with the edit one, and it should match with this one. Okay, we are adding assertion in this, right? I hope that makes sense. It is very important to use find and first. Similarly, first we have last also, and if you want to, now the question will be like, how do I get to the middle one, right? I want to get it to another one. So what you can do, you have a very interesting method which is called as each. I'll explain you this concept. Okay, so suppose I have a server running at this one. So let me see if I am in the server or not. Yes, so I have a UL tag, and similarly coffee is there, right? So I have an unordered list. coffee to an ordered list and with the ID of drinks. And we have the first one as a lift, coffee, tea, and milk. I want to basically get the coffee, tea, and milk, everyone, right? I will get everyone, but if we do first, it will be again. We can do directly like basically cy.get dot basically the first, right? Find li, basically li we have already given, so we can do dot first, so it will give me coffee. We'll do last, it will give me milk, but I want to get everyone. So what we can do is that we can use each. So for this one, it's very similar to each. We'll get all the elements indexed and the list element. So element.text if we do, so all the element will be printed. And for list, for example, if when we are done with it, we can check that list should have a 3 LIs that we can do, right? So it is again, Cypress is all about passing and it's all about promises, right? So it will basically, after it's done, it has done this thing, it will basically returns that, okay, this is the list which contains all the p tag. That for that you can check the length also, right? So another important thing that I wanted to tell you, that if you want to play with cookies, you can do basically set cookie. You need to pass basically using a kind of a key value pair. You can get cookie also. Similarly, you can use window. Window is basically the object here. For example, if you get the window here, so this object will be available with ci.window. Again, it will basically gives you as a, you can say as a promise. So you can check its. So basically, if you want, if you have, for example, the window have width of, so there are like lots of properties available there, right? And suppose I want to check window dot inner height, so it's to 428, right? But I've told you that whenever we are running the Cypress test, it should, it's 1000, right? So that's what we are doing, right? So let me run this one so that you will get to understand what's going on, right? So let me run this one and it will basically do the each one. So you know how to use first, you know how to use last, but if you wanted to know how to iterate, which everyone can do that. Okay, there. It started. Going to open the URL, right? And it's basically quickly done it. It was very fast, but if you get the gist, will not get the gist. Let me do one thing. I'll add some weight, cy.weight. Can add longer weight here, see what's going on, right? See, you can also add debugger also, cy.debug, but I prefer to use wait because so all right, so you can set the cookie, you can get the cookie here. Hey, this is the elements. You can basically get the whenever you are getting the element, we have a all the elements, we are checking the length. Yes, you can get the its inner width expected to be equal. So I think so most of the commands I have already covered in this video. And I'll share you the source code in the file in the GitHub repository, or you know, that you can use it. If you have any kind of question, let me know. Do check out the Cypress documentation; it's awesome. Don't forget to subscribe. If you like this video, please like and share. And if you think this video is helpful for anyone, it is free, right? Please share with your friends, and will basically boost my morale. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day, and you're awesome because since you have watched till the end, and see you in the next video.